Hello, good morning dear students. Welcome to our Gyan Jyoti online classes. So today we will discuss about the 10th chapter of our history book, and the chapter name is India's Struggle for Freedom. Okay, first, India's Struggle for Freedom start. The phase of our freedom struggle, okay, is divided into two time periods. Okay, the first, you can say the first phase, okay, started from 1885 to 1919, and this age was known as also, you can say, pre-Gandhian period. Okay, and the second phase, which was started from 1992 till our independence 1947. Okay, that period you can say was known as post-Gandhian period. So our freedom struggle mostly divided into two phases. Okay, the pre-Gandhian period or the first phase one, which was 1885 to 1919, and what the post-Gandhian period, which was from 1990 to 1947. Okay, so let's start the chapter from the failure of the revolt of 1857. Okay, 1857, the Sepoy Mutiny, or you can say the first freedom struggle of Indian people. Okay, it was a failure, you can say, revolution, but it was, you can say, awakened the Indian people to fight, unitedly fight against the Britishers. Okay, after what, 1857, after Sepoy Mutiny, okay, the nationalism, the feeling of nationalism, you can say, was arose in the heart of every Indian people. Okay, and these are the factors, were responsible for growth of nationalism idea in the mind of Indian people. Okay, first, unification, second, modern education, third, glorification of Indian, what, India's past, and about prince. So in this chapter, we will discuss about the, you can say, the event from 1885 to 1990. Okay, and it was known as, you can say, the first phase of India's freedom struggle. Got it? So first, unification. So Britishers, you can say, occupied India, okay, and they were, you can say, united administrative policy or administrative system. That's why they, the Britishers, they were what, make India as a unified state or country. Got it? The British had unified the country administratively and economically for their own purposes. Okay, for, you can say, for comfortable administration and for comfortable in collecting what, revenue. That's why the Britishers had unified the country administratively and economically, but their policy had harmful impact on the lives of the Indian people. It what, awakened an united people against the British rule and created an anti-imperialist movement. Anti-imperialist means the vision of the Britishers to occupy what, the whole Indian territory. Okay, and you can say the mindset, the ideology of, you can say, what, extend territory is known as the idea of imperialism. Okay, so by, you can say, the Indian were fed up by the policies of what, the Britishers. Okay, that's why, and they were, you can say, suffered by, you can, the Indians were suffered by the revenue policies as well as administrative rules and regulations of what, the Britishers. That's why what, they awakened and what, the policies, it awakened and united people against the British rule and created an anti-imperialist movement. Okay, however, you can say, before the British arrival in India, okay, the Indian territories, the Indian people, you can say, were different from each other on basis of what, territory, on basis of, you can say, religion, on basis on basis of their customs and culture. Okay, but for their own purpose, for their, you can say, comfortability, what the Britishers, United India, India, United Indian Peoples, United Indian Territory, okay. And after that, what the United People, okay, they were was started movement against the imperialist government, against the colonial government. So what the unification of the people, which was made by, or you can say performed by the Britishers, okay, this was one of the most important factors which grew the nationalism feeling in the heart of every Indian people against the British rule. Okay, after that, modern education. We had already discussed about the modern education system, which was, you can say, implemented by the Britishers, okay, which was gave very much potentiality, you can very much positivity to the Indian society, okay. So through the modern education, the people, they were able to what gain knowledge about the ideologies like what nationalism, the liberty means freedom, okay, about the rights, okay, rights, fundamental rights, okay, then about you can say about fraternity or brotherhood. So what this modern education system was also gave very much what impact to arouse what nationalism in the mind of every Indian people. Got it? Then the glorification of India's past, the educated class also glorified India's past. Educated what people of India or educationalists, they were always what glorifies India's past. Moreover, racial arrogance of the rulers led the Indian people to think as one against the British. The reformers has already created a national social consciousness. Okay, so by the modern education system, the people of India, they were able to get modern education facilities. Okay, so they were educated class. Okay, after they get education, they were started to glorify India's past. Okay, means what type of, you can say, living style they had, okay, what type of, you can say, rules and regulations through they were, you can say, regulated by the rulers, okay. So this type of, you can say, the glorification or glorify Indian history, they were, we can say, presented in front of Indian people, okay. And it also one of the most important, you can say, factors which was responsible for make Indian people in a united form. Got it? Then about press, or you can say media. Then press played a significant role in the spread of modern ideas and awakening people's spread of national outlook took place through developing Indian languages and the popular Indian language press. Okay. Yes, in present time also, what the press played an important role, plays an important role to unite people, to awake people about the, you can say, about the circumstances. Okay, so press played a significant role in the spread of modern ideas and awaking people through the press, through, you can say, newspapers, then through, you can say, magazines, the people were able to what know about the harsh policies, or you can say the negative policies of the Britishers against the Indians. Okay, the press was weapon of nationalist, that's why what the British tried to what curtail freedom of expression. The nationalist newspaper criticized the anti-people policies of the British. Thus, they what fostered political ideas and sense of belongingness to India. Okay, sense of belongingness means, you can say, unity. Got it? So the anti-people policies of policies of the Britishers, anti-Indian rules and regulations by the Britishers, the nationalists, okay, who were, you can say, tried to what arouse the nationalism or love for the motherland feelings in the deep heart of every Indian people. Okay, they were, you can say, they were raised their voice against the Britishers, and they were tried to unite Indian people in a single unit through their writing skills. Okay, through, and they choose the medium of what prints, through newspapers, okay, through magazines, through different kind of writings, or what nationalist book, they were what tried to you can send their messages or spread their messages among the Indian people through press. Okay, then racial arrogance of the British led to awaken Indians. The British humiliated Indians and branded them all the bondage of inferiority. The racial, you can say, the racial arrogance means the color difference between the Indians and, you can say, the Britishers. The Britishers hated the Indian people, okay, you can say, according to their body color, okay. So this type of racial arrogance practiced by, you can say, the Britishers is also one of the most important factors responsible for awakened Indian people against British rule. Got it? So after that, racial arrogance of the Britishers towards the Indians was also one of the most important factors for united the Indian people, okay, against the colonial rule. After that, Lord Lytton, or you can say the Viceroy of that period, what Lytton's provocative measures means some, you can say, against the Indians, okay. He was implemented some rules and regulations. Okay, so Viceroy Lord Lytton introduced anti-Indian measures during his viceroyalty 1876 to 1880. These 4 years, okay, he took anti-Indian measures. These measures, as least what these measures are. Lytton removed import duties on British textiles. It hurt Indian textile industries. To dominate the Indian textile industries. Okay, what Lytton removed import duties on British import duties means tax barrier. Okay, he enforced Arms Act to deprive Indians from acquiring arms for self defense. Okay, so through the Arms Act, the Indians were also able to what kept weapons, okay, for their, you can say, self defense measure. But what Lord Lytton or Viceroy Lytton what enforced Arms Act to deprive Indians, enforcement is regulated Arms Act, and through the Arms Act what you can say, the Indian people didn't have any right to what kept any arm for their self defense. Only on the Britishers were able to, you can say, took the you can say, or kept the arm for their self defense through the Arms Act. Okay, then Lytton also caught growing criticism of British rule. Thus Indians were deprived of the freedom of expression. Okay, what Lord Lytton also denied the freedom of expression of Indians. Okay, that's why you can say the Indians were what united against the anti-Indian measures of Viceroy Lytton. Okay, then Lord Lytton, he also reduced the age of compensation from 21 to 19 for Indian civil services examination. It hit the educated aspirants very badly. Got it? In the field of civil service examinations, the age of compensation from 21, okay, to 19. Then the Indian educationalists, okay, you can say, who had the wish to face civil services examinations, okay, means they were, you can say, the educationalists, they were what, totally against this type of, you can say, laws formulated by, you can say, Lord Lytton. Got it? Then, last but not the least, he waged war against Afghanistan. India bore the cost of war. Okay, what the British government war against Afghanistan, but India what bore the cost of war. That's why what the Indian people what you can say made a single unit and started movement against what Britishers and Lord Lytton. So Lord Lytton's measures or Lord Lytton's, you can say, steps were also one of the most important, you can say, factors to what make the Indians or arouse the angerness among the Indians against what British government. Got it? Then the educated middle class created political association, thus ultimately resulted in the establishment of the Indian National Congress or INC. Okay. INC, Indian National Congress. So what? The educated middle class created political association. Okay, to what? To, you can say, to protest against the British rule. The ultimately resulted in the establishment of the Indian National Congress. Means the educated middle class, they were created the political association like Indian National Congress, or you can say INC. The feelings of solidarity got stronger during the course of the freedom struggle, contributing to the formation of the Indian nation. Okay, so let's discuss about when did the Indian National Congress was formed. Okay, in the year of 1885. Got it? By whom did the Indian National Congress was formed, and the main aim or ambitions of what Indian National Congress. So the Indians needed an all Indian organization to provide a common platform and spread what awareness among the local masses or people, you can say. Indian National Congress came up in 1885. When? 1885. AOQ. The founder of Indian National Congress. What? It was came up in 1885. The Indian leaders cooperated with Alan Octavian Hume or A.O. Hume, a retired English civil servant. Okay? A retired English civil servant to start the Indian National Congress. So, the Indian National Congress or INC was set up by a retired English civil servant named Alan Octavian Hume or A.O. Hume in the year of 1885. Okay, and it united the Indian people or Indian masses and started movement against the British government. Got it? So the first session of the Indian National Congress was held at Mumbai from December 28 to 31, 1885. The first session of Indian National Congress, or you can say the first meeting, okay, or assembly of the Indian National Congress was held at Mumbai from December 28 to 31, 1885, under the presidency of Umesh Chandra Banerjee. Okay, the first president of, you can say, the first president of Indian National Congress, okay, was Umesh Chandra Banerjee, under the leadership or presidency of Umesh Chandra Banerjee. The Congress was held its first session in December 28 to 31 in 1885. Then it was attended by 72 delegates from all over the country. 72 delegates, you can say, educationalists or guests who were participated in what, the first session of Congress. Some of the great presidents of the National Congress during its real early years were Dadabhai Naroji, okay, Badruddin Tyabji. Dadabhai Naroji, what leading, you can say, freedom struggle, freedom struggler of India. He also, you can say, discovered, you can say, the theory of drain of wealth, which was practiced by what the British government. Okay, they were drained the wealth from India to England. Okay, and you can say the Indians didn't have any economic benefit from import and export work of the Britishers. Okay, so you can say they were monopolily what regulated the trading system of India, and through the one-way trade they were able to, you can say, kept a huge amount of wealth from India. So the early years, Dada Bhai Naroji, Badruddin Tarji, Firoz Shah Mehta, okay, P. Anand Chalu, Surendranath Banerjee, Gopal Krishna Gokhale, okay, so these are the prominent leaders or president of Indian National Congress in early years. Okay, then the main objectives, okay, or main aim of Indian National Congress, to strengthen the feelings of national unity, okay, to strong, okay, to you can say, to make the bondage of the people of India, okay, or you can say in another sentence that the Indian National Congress or INC, okay, it always trying to what or try to make the Indian people in a single unit, to strengthen the feelings of national unity, or you can say the feeling of nationalism. Then to formulate guidelines for future plan of action in public interest, to formulate what guidelines or to form law for future plan means for freedom struggle against the Britishers, action in public interest through the united public. They you can say they formulated the guidelines, the principle through means the Indians, you can say, were protest against the Britishers, to train and organize public opinion in the country. Okay, then the early nationalists, the moderates, okay, the early you can say the moderates and the extremists, got it, the moderate you can say their ambitions, you can say, to got independence through the violence, okay, through the, you can say, non violence, okay, means the public strike, they were organized, okay, they were you can say protested against the Britishers in a lawful manner, got it, that's why we can call that community as what, the moderates. And the extremists, okay, they strongly believe in what, non violence act, okay, and what they thought, that through the violence act, through the war, okay, what the Indians will gain freedom or independence. Okay, this difference, you can say, this differences of ideology create two what, two community, two different types of you can people, or two different types of what groups in Indian politics, in Indian history, that is what, the moderates and the extremists. So during the what first 20 years, 1885 to 1905, of Indian National Congress, the moderates held supreme. Many eminent persons such as Dada Bhai Naroji, okay, W.C. Banerjee, K.T. Talang, Firoz Shah Mehta, Badruddin Tyabji, G. Subramanyam Iyer, and G. what, Chandravarkar, Justice Rana Day, and what, Behram Ji Malavari were among the leading persons. Okay, during the early phase, political liberation of the country was not on the agenda of the National Congress. Instead, it worked to arouse and consolidate national feelings and train the people in politics and political agitation. The Congress educated the people with the effect of imperialism, struggle for was constitutional, administrative and other reforms, and stood in defense of civil rights. Okay, so you can say in the moderates, they were tried to arouse the what, nationalism feelings under the masses, Indian masses. Okay, and they targeted what, you can say, educated people of Indian society. Through the educated people, they were tried to spread
the you can say spread the idea of civil rights, okay, then constitutional constitutional manner or administrative system, got it. So moderates mostly believe the lawful manner to got what freedom or independence. So under moderates, the Congress spread the idea that India must be ruled in the interest of the Indians, okay. In a way, the early nationalists laid foundations for the national movement to grow open, got it. Then their method of political works, as late as 1905, moderate nationalists, or you can say moderates, led the national movement. They work within the framework of law. The Congress met each year in different places, passed resolution and would submit petition to the government. It wanted to convince the government and therefore avoided what confrontation with the British. In early period, the moderates, okay, they were, you can say, put the petition against the government, okay, because they wanted to, you can say, rule India according to the Indians, not through the British. Okay, then let's discuss about what kind of government attitude towards the moderates. The British authorities did not meet even the moderate demands of the Congress. They were hostile to the rising nationalist movement. The British tried to drive a wedge between Hindus and Muslims. So what the government or the British government didn't give much more, you can say, intention or eyes over the demand of you can say a moderates leader, okay, as well as they were trying to, you can say, start riots or conflict between Hindu people and what Muslim people. So you can say the British government what divided the Indian people on basis of what religion, as Hindu and Muslim. After that, rise of radicals, or you can say the extremist people, Indians had become the recognized that the purpose of British rule was to exploit India, and they would not accept Indians' demands. Many leaders wanted to adopt radical approach because what the ideology, or you can say the demands of moderates, okay, It was not considered, or these were not considered by the Britishers. They were totally avoided the demands of moderates leader. That's why the radicals, or you can say the extremists, were arose in the Indian society, and they were what started to oppose the British government. The radical leadership took over the movement in the wake of the partition of Bengal. Okay. Lokmanya Tilak, Bipin Chandra Pal, Aurobindo Ghosh and Lala Lajpat Rai were the most outstanding leaders of militant nationalism. Okay, they believed in war. The new leadership had faith in the strength of the masses and wanted to achieve Swaraj through mass action. The mass radicals or the extremists involved the masses on a large scale and raised the enthusiasm level of the people. The accumulated anger found expression in the movement against the partition of Bengal in 1905. So in 1905, the Bengal partition was happened, okay, and the British government means the British government what made the partition of Bengal of 1905, okay. After that, the extremists, they were very activated in among the Indians, and they were tried to what spread their ideologies or extremist ideology in the Indian people. After partition of Bengal, what the extremists were, you can say, the extremists were, they were united the Indian masses, Indian people, and they were started the protest. They were started, you can say, a war against what? The colonial rule. Got it? After that, the extremists like Lokmanya Tilak, Bipin Chandra Pal, Lala Lajpat Rai, they were activated in Indian society and they were aroused the extremist idea among the Indian people to what? To make war against the British policies. After what? Bengal partition of 1905. Okay? Then the idea of Swadeshi and boycott. Means the idea of Swadeshi means they were, you can say, motivated the Indian people to what? To get or to purchase the Indian goods and boycott the foreign goods which were what promoted by what? The British government in the Indian market. Okay, they were, you can say, exported the British goods to India and in Indian market they were totally declined the industries, Indian industries, and the, you can say, the value of Indian goods were also decreased by the what? By the English product, okay, because they were sell their product in very cheap manner, in very low price in the Indian market. That's why Indian goods were what lost its value in the Indian society. Then, with the announcement of the partition of Bengal in 1905. The national movement entered the second stage. Okay, with the express purpose of dividing what the Bengalis on religious grounds, Lord Curzon issued an order dividing the province of Bengal, 20 July 1905. The main motive for the partition of Bengal, according to the British, was that Bengal was too big to be administered efficiently by a single government. However, the real and what concealed motives were, British wanted to weaken the freedom movement as Bengal was the center of Indian nationalism at that time. So at that time, the nationalist movement were, you can say, raised highly in the province of Bengal. But the Britishers, they were wanted to repress the nationalist movement in Bengal. Okay, at that time Bengal unitedly against the British government. That's why through the religious view and through the territorial or geographical, you can say, statistic, the Britishers gave a reason to the Indians or INC that what Bengal was divided because its geographical area was vast. Okay, but what through the Bengal partition, the Britishers, you can say, divided the Indian people into two groups, Hindu and Muslim, and they were able to succeed or repress the nationalist movement in Bengal. Okay, and under the leadership of Lord Curzon, the Bengal partition was happened in 1905. Then, to create Hindu-Muslim enmity or what you can say, to create the conflict between Hindu and Muslim, that's why Lord Curzon what done that action of Bengal partition. All nationalists stood together to oppose the partitions. Okay, the freedom struggler, the educationalist, the nationalist, okay, of Indian politics, they were stood together to oppose the partition or oppose the Bengal partition. The radicals came into forefront. Okay, the radical or you can say the extremists, they were activated or came into forefront or ahead. All the leaders organized massive demonstration, hartals and fast or you can say strikes. Okay, the nationalists, the leaders of India, okay, they were started hartal or doing, and they were started what strike against the Britishers. The people protested, the Swadeshi and boycott movement was lost. Okay, so after what 1905, after Bengal partition, the extremists or the Indian leaders, Indian freedom fighters, they were against what the British government, against the policy of Bengal partition. Okay, they were launched many strikes, many hartal, many fast, and the masses, the Indian people were also joined them, and after that the people what were followed Swadeshi and boycott movement, got it, by the extremists, by the Indian leaders, the Swadeshi and boycott movement you can say was launched against the British government. Okay, so this is all about today's class. After in our next class we will discuss about the anti-partition movement. Okay, after that Congress splits, the Surat session 1907, then the first impact of First World War in what Indian society, in Indian politics, or you can say in administrative policy of the Britishers. After that the Gandhi era was began. Okay, and the struggling life of Mahatma Gandhi, and also what type of action were, you can say what type of you can say in the freedom struggle of India. Okay, what kind of role was played by Mahatma Gandhi. Got it? So thank you very much. Stay home, stay safe.